Woohoo! A beautiful day in the neighborhood. So here we are, our third attempt at shooting this video for you guys. Gets dark too soon these days. We're gonna take the beast out and maybe groom up the trail for the old fella. And check the ice, if it's not too thick. These old girls haven't been started since the last time, which is, what, a month and a half ago?
Yeah, I
guess we should wind that 13. Up. Wind that up. So we're going to see how it goes. It's going to be an old start, cold start, I guess. They have battery tenders on them, but still counts.
Puppet shadow.
So yeah, we had such a cold snap, nothing was happening, and now it's warmed up a bit. I think it's minus, what did they say, minus four?
Minus four right now.
See how the old grizz fires up. Can-Am's got brand new brakes on, haven't even tried it yet with them. They're so nice and clean. Here we go. Let the... Oh, contact.
A little chuggy.
Should have let the pump run for a second before you try, but it went okay. Back it out and then we can let it warm up. Tight fit. Now my beast of burden. My charger had a different plug than my... than I usually use, so I had to use clamps on my battery. Look at all these sheds sweat. I don't know if you can see that, but they drip water all over everything.
Yeah, that's the bad thing about them.
You can see it there, laying there.
Condensation.
I'll give you those. Look at it on the pipes. It's just dripping.
Because it's warm.
It's dripolating.
When it's 30 below, it's frozen.
I think we better go for the real key here. No doubt she's missed me, the old girl. Or not. Oh, yeah. She's a little hesitant, though. Who wouldn't be?
They are nice and clean.
My hand and thumb warmers.
Oh yeah, that's a new feature for you this year.
Everything good there?
Yeah, if you go straight back, because you don't want to hit the saw.
That's out. That's all that matters.
Oh, the ram?
So we'll let these warm up a bit. Maybe put some gasoline antifreeze in them, and then we'll carry on. Okay, let's give this a try. We're going to hook up to the little drag up here. It's a bit of snow, I don't know. Not a lot. 6 inches. Looks like the deer been chewing the grass there. See how it goes, I guess.
Kind of on a lean here, but...
an eye-lean. I can't fit. Oh, I'm rubbing. Puffing with all these clothes on. Oh. Watch you don't get that up the butt. So our little drag's probably frozen in there. Oh yeah, she is.
I'm trying to find the rope.
Oh, she's stiff. Where is the rope? Right there. What's left of it? Harry. That's Harry. Mm-hmm. In the Henderson.
Gotta flip it over.
No, I think it would be best to go this way. Okay, hook her on there. Been cold, but when we're walking in the back, there wasn't any frost in the swamp, so hopefully we don't sink out of sight. Okay, here we go.
Big ruts here now.
Keep moving or you're going to slide in that tree. Just go. Keep moving. Yeah, yeah. Oh, watch out. Oh, you bounced her off there like a pinball.
Oh, that was close.
I know, professional. Do not attempt that at home. They're still kind of leaning upwards, but...
I'll go straight here and then turn.
Maybe we should flip them over, eh? Wow, these grips are hot. Can you flip them? Let me try driving on it again.
Right in the middle, there. That's where they were sticking up.
There, that looks better. Warranty on that. It doesn't look that great, actually. Somebody was in here when it was really wet and got it all rutted up. So, it's kind of tricky for walking, but might take a bit of time, but she'll fill in the ruts. I gotta go to a bigger gear here.
It's so mild out today, I just have these little mitts on because my hand warmers are so hot.
I gotta turn mine down, actually, now that you mention that. So, yeah, we haven't been out, I don't know if I said November or September before, but since November the 11th or 13th or something like that, so like 6 weeks, but... Part of it was because of the extreme cold, and now it's just finally warmed up. I think it's minus four today. And the rest is because I'm still screwed up. I know, I know. Have some good days, like today's pretty good. And been seeing the doctors lots. I got to go again next week. I actually did see the specialist for my tumor, just in case that's what was causing it. And everything's good with that. Had an ultrasound and stuff, so that's good. I'm good for a year with him. So I guess I'll find out more next week. But like I said, I got good days, and today's one of them, so let's ride. We're hoping to check the thickness of the ice, but I've heard that it's like already over a foot. So if it is, I don't think our little power saw is going to make it through.
Well, it's been a rough fall, that's for sure, with Cubbee being sick, and then our pups had some issues.
Jethro and Oliver.
Our older boy, he had to have some surgery to remove a fatty lump and some warts and
some
a couple
teeth.
And then we found a little lump on Oliver, and it turned out it ended up being a mast cell tumor, but thankfully it was low grade. And
just found out yesterday?
Just found out, yeah, yesterday after the pathology report came back that the kind that it is shouldn't have spread or anything, and...
Cut it all out.
Margin, so they got it all out, and he doesn't have to have any other treatment. Just got to monitor him.
Left.
But yeah, it's definitely been a fall to remember, and hopefully now we'll get Cubbee sorted out and get to do
good luck with that. So yeah, hopefully things start going a little better, and we can make some winter videos soon. I think I still got a few summer ones to come, but it would be better to have some winter ones for sure.
That probably could be broken there.
Could have been shorter, but good enough for now. Yeah, so like 2.5 weeks ago, if you follow us on Facebook, and if you don't, you really should, because you miss a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff, and Instagram, and Twitter, and all that good stuff. If you follow us on Facebook, you would see that 2 weeks ago, the lake had no ice on it at all. Well, 2.5 weeks. And then last weekend already, they were driving vehicles across the ice road. That's how cold it's been here.
Yeah, that's a fast freeze.
I'll say. Crazy.
And what did we hear? 14 inches of ice?
Well, that's what we heard, but I don't know. We'll stick our little saw in here and see what it is. I don't think I'll be able to cut 14 inches. I'm not sure what the length of the bar is on it, but we'll give it a try. She's definitely frozen. Is there any tracks out there? Looks like snow machine tracks over there, right?
Over there. Maybe some slush there. That looks like fun.
Whoa, that may made me dizzy. Whew. Who's your daddy? Well, let's take a check on the ice here. See how it goes.
Okay.
So yeah, if the ice is as thick as they say it is, I don't think my little saw's gonna go through there, but we'll see. How long is that? About 15 inches. And if they got a foot of ice, oh, it's gonna be tricky. We're not gonna work too hard at it. We'll just see how it goes. Pretty darn thick. I don't think it's a foot though. Too many clothes on, I can't breathe. Sucked up some water.
Oh boy.
Should be loose in there. Try this again.
I think on the side close.
Oh, there we go.
Woohoo!
Who's your daddy? Let's see if we can get that out of there. Quit puffing. Oh, I broke it. That ain't gonna work. That'll work.
Push it up. Now we don't know how deep
yeah.
it was.
Well, we'll use the tape measure. You can just reach. Where is the tape measure? You can just reach your arm in there. Okay, well, I didn't get that block out, so let's see if I can hook the tape measure on the bottom. I don't know if I can do this. Stick the camera down there. Oh, that brick's underneath it then. That isn't going to work. There, hooked on the edge. What does it say? Yep. There, right
10
there.
10 inches.
10 inches?
Yep.
Anything down there? Nothing swimming around in there.
Get your fishy. It's about 10 inches, right? Huh? Can't be much deeper than that right there.
I'm hooked on the edge of it right there.
Yeah.
Huh? She's pretty deep.
Yeah.
Or pretty thick, I guess you'd say. Hope that camera's waterproof.
I guess we'll find out.
Muskie! Light's still on. So yeah, 10 inches is pretty good for this time of year.
Considering 2 weeks ago it was wide open.
I'm sure there's bad spots and stuff, but... It's like a beautiful day in the neighborhood, though.
Yeah.
I got so dizzy over there, I nearly fell off. Oh, well. That was fun, but I guess we got to get going, so better start heading back. A little video for you, anyways. So, yeah. I don't imagine we'll have any other videos before Christmas, so I guess we should just take this opportunity to thank everybody, and Merry Christmas, and Happy Holidays, and Season Greetings, whichever one works for you.
Thanks to all our viewers and subscribers and people who reach out to us.
Facebook followers and Instagram, all of you.
So we still can't believe how our little hobby has turned into our CubbeeZX channel. Just amazing. You guys are all awesome. Sure appreciate all the likes and the thumbs up and the comments, and really means a lot to us.
One thing you should mention, though, is others have probably seen this on YouTube, how YouTube has been screwing around with the algorithms or something, how you recommend videos, so everyone's views have been going down. So if you want to continue to ensure that you catch our videos, where is it?
Oh, you just have to make sure you're subscribed, and then on the channel you'll see a little bell.
Maybe I'll put a picture right here. A little bell, you click on that and click on the receive email notification so you're sure not to miss any new videos. And although we really hate saying this, but if you really do like our videos, if you could just hit that like button when you watch one, that's really going to help out the channel, especially now that YouTube's changed stuff around. We'd really appreciate that. And if you don't like it, well, I guess that doesn't really matter. Especially that guy in Hungary. Big thanks to you. You know who you are. You're pretty quick with that dislike button every single video, but we appreciate you watching.
It's still a view.
Yes, it is. So I think that's just about going to wrap up the video for today. And like I said, hope everyone has a good holiday season, and hopefully I'm feeling better so we can make some winter videos. I'm feeling a little dizzy right now, though.
Donut.
Oh! I don't know. Should we even say anything yet? I don't know. What do you think?
Oh, you could say it.
We kind of got some good news, but it's like 99.9% going through, but with my luck, the 0.1% will happen and it won't be true. But anyways, if it is, so what?
So we were contacted by Shaw Direct, which is the satellite company in Canada. And if you subscribe to Shaw Direct, I think they bought Star Choice a few years ago. They have about 1 million subscribers across Canada.
National satellite TV provider.
Right. So CubbeeZX ATV Adventures is going to start being played nationally across the country on the Shaw Channel. Yeah, I know.
That's if the 0.1%, the little one last little detail goes through, but the way it's looking right now, it is, and apparently it's going to be on
Channel 299.
As we hear more, we'll be sure to let you know, but
yeah, so if you're anywhere in Canada and have subscribed to Shaw Direct TV with the satellite, then you'll be able to watch us.
Of course, we're still going to be available in northwestern Ontario and central Manitoba on the local Shaw cable TV channel.
And YouTube.
And YouTube, yeah. But, you're only in two-wheel drive?
No.
Yeah?
No.
I didn't see this wheel spin.
No.
I was just about a tree eater.
That was?
So, yeah, we thought that was pretty awesome that they contacted us. I don't know. I don't know what you think, but watch for us there in the new year.
Merry Christmas, everybody, and Happy New Year.
See y'all next year. Well, maybe before then. Who knows? Thanks again to everyone. We really appreciate it.
Thanks,
bye.
Everybody. Bye.
Oh my God. Oh, that's not funny.